Seasonal units have been a thing in Conqueror's Blade since Season 2. Since then, going back to get season units is a challenge players face, as there are always new units to work on as well. With this challenge, there is one seasonal unit that avoids this problem, and that is the Pavise from Season 3. This unit is the only seasonal unit that is available in the honor tree. So is it worth spending all that honor, or the long time doing seasonal challenges? Pavise are a 5-star golden era unit from Season 3. They cost 325 leadership in your warband. They are easy to spot on the battlefield with their large shields and crossbows. Pavise have 4 traits. Soldiers of Fortune. During Season 3, this unit's leadership cost is reduced by 10, and to replace its kit costs 50% less. Shield Bearers. This unit carries shields to protect themselves while reloading. Penetrating Shots. Crossbows can penetrate the first target and injure another behind the first. Fire Resistant. This unit's armor is less vulnerable to thermal weapons than other units of the same era. Pavise can be commanded into 2 formations. The first formation is the Dispersed Formation. This is excellent for reducing the impact of incoming ranged attacks. There is also the Shield Wall Formation. This is great for concentrating your unit and defending in one direction with their shields. There are 3 unit orders available for Pavise. The first is Direct Fire. The unit spreads out and continuously fires at the designated area. There is also the Toggle Shields command. This toggles between the shields being wielded or on their backs. With their shields in front, the unit can shoot bolts while defending. With their shields on their backs, they can shoot bolts that impale their enemies. There is also the Patan Bolts command. The unit switches to using heavier projectiles that reduce enemy defenses by 250 for 4 seconds. They also knock enemies back. There are 2 veterancy lines for the Pavise. Before either line, there is a 5% increase to armor penetration. The top line has a focus on the Baton Bolts unit order. There are great boons such as increases to cavalry damage, armor penetration, rate of fire, and the big one is Baton Bolts have a 20% chance to stun enemy units. This line is a damage dealing focus with the added utility. The bottom line has a focus on defense and survivability. There are great boons with ammo increase, defense increases, damage taken reductions, and firing can inflict 100 block break. The bottom is all about that survivability with the utility in movement speed, ammo, and block breaks. Pavise are a solid unit for supporting a front line. The ability to use shields for reducing incoming counter-ranged fire makes them a great unit. Since they should not be taking direct damage behind a line, and the shield does help with counter-fire, I usually recommend running the top line. The stun with Baton Bolts is great for stopping charges that are coming towards your frontline defenses. Baton Bolt to counter charges, especially cavalry, is a great strategy that the top line helps support. As for doctrines, I personally run the Pavise Crossbowman's Doctrine 3, Piercing Doctrine, Epic Crossbow Doctrines 3, 4, and 5. Though if I had it available, I would swap out the Piercing Doctrine for an Epic Crossbow Doctrine 2. This build focuses the Pavise. The damage increase, rate of fire increase, and shooting accuracy are generally good boons. Epic Crossbow Doctrine 5 gives the Pavise the unit order double shot. This allows them to fire 2 bolts per a shot for 8 seconds. This is excellent for a concentrated volley when the enemy pushes forward, or to shoot down a charging warlord that is going to try to clear your unit. A couple other good options for doctrines are the Breakthrough Doctrine or the Epic Crossbow Doctrine 1. The Epic Doctrine increases ammo. I would not run this long term, but it is a great option when you are missing a better one. The biggest thing to keep in mind is that Pavise can have a severe reduction to their rate of fire. When the unit is defending in the shield wall formation, they will reduce their rate of fire due to only half of the soldiers being able to shoot. If they are in dispersed formation, or you use direct fire to spread them out, each soldier will defend themselves and shoot. With that being said, it can be tempting to just set them up with their shields and leave them alone, but this will drastically reduce their impact since their rate of fire drops. You should only have the shields out when in shield wall when it is necessary for them to protect themselves from enemy fire. Even with that in mind, if they are taking enemy fire, it may be necessary to put the shields away or use the dispersed formation to unleash a quick volley to counter an enemy charge. Pavis do respectable damage, but their biggest benefit is as a support unit for your allies. Their stuns and knockback with Baton Bolt will help your allies clear enemies, as well as protect them from strong charging attacks if timed correctly. Pavis are a strong unit when used properly, and one that I love having on my team. With that being said, they are a unit you only want a few of on your team. At 325 leadership, I would say if you have a leadership cap above the default 700, then they are a great choice to add to your warband. As for honor versus unit challenges, the doctrine I recommended from the challenges can easily be swapped for the breakthrough doctrine. So I would say if you don't want to take the time working on the challenges, I would easily say spend the honor. I hope this video gave you a look at Pavis. If you enjoyed it, please consider helping the channel out by liking the video. This video was brought by a video suggestion. If you have one as well, comment down below letting me know what you want to see. With that, until next time, I'll see you on the battlefield. Nice. That teamwork. Frozen and bopped.